ICICI Lombard and CNBC-TV18 present the India Risk Management Awards.
A special panel discussion on managing new age risks was conducted by ICICI Lombard and CNBC-TV18 as a part of the India Risk Management Awards. The event saw a distinguished set of panelists discussing the key findings and takeaways of ICICI Lombard's report titled Understanding New Age Risks.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the India Risk Management Awards presented by ICICI Lombard and CNBC-TV18. Today's event is a special panel discussion on managing new age risks. In today's globalized and deeply integrated worlds, risk management is an important strategic tool for the sustainable growth of organizations in corporate India. What we have for you today is a power-packed panel discussion on managing new age risks that is based on a research study conducted by ICICI Lombard, which saw participation from 100 key opinion leaders across various sectors. Without further ado, let's flag off this wonderful evening. I would like to invite on stage A.B. Ravi, Editor Special Project CNBC TV 18, to address the gathering. A huge round of applause for Mr. A.B. Ravi.
Today's CROs face newer and newer kind of risk. In fact, their risk spectrum has widened. Threat of fire, cyclone, and earthquake is always there. But the impact of these calamities have assumed new dimensions. Risks surrounding big data and cybersecurity are emerging as big threat as the geopolitical uncertainty deepens. This uncertainty is all the more disturbing at a time of rising ultra-nationalism, caste and sectarian conflict, and trade protectionism. And these new age risks are all pervasive and come from the most unexpected quarters. Let me give you two examples. We all know that the film industry by definition is risky, but by roping in superstars and well-known director, one could hope for a box office hit. It was a formula that worked once upon a time, not anymore. Today, there are fringe elements who could scuttle the release of movies and put producers in a tight spot. We saw that happen during the release of The Accidental Prime Minister. Earlier, we saw how the movie Padmavati ran into all kinds of problems. The second one is casteism risk. It is on the rise. Different parts of the country have witnessed caste-based agitation. It was Maratha reservations in Maharashtra, Patidas in Gujarat, Gujars in Rajasthan, and Jats in Haryana. These agitations are disrupting the economy and the process corporate India. Given this kind of fluid situation, ICICI Lombard, with a view to guide corporate India, commissioned a study to find out what are the new age risks and how to prevent it. Today's discussion will focus on these findings. The discussion is an integral part of a flagship property, the India Risk Management Award, which was instituted 5 years ago by CNBC TV18 in partnership with ICICI Lombard. India Risk Management recognizes, honors, and the CEOs who have been able to anticipate challenges by putting in place a robust risk management that helps maximize profits and minimize risk. That, to my mind, is a daunting task for any CEO in today's real-time, interconnected, and interdependent world. They literally have to run with the hare and hunt with the hound. So they have to follow the motto of Boy Scout, be ready. Before I go, here's an interesting observation made by Mark Zuckerberg of Facebook, and I quote him. The biggest risk is not taking any risk. In a world that is changing really quickly, the only strategy that is guaranteed to fail is not taking any risk. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Mr. Ravi, for setting the tone for the evening. These are indeed uncertain times, and today's CEO faces risk on all fronts, from geopolitical to technological disruption risk, judicial and legislative risk, and even social media risks. To shed more light on the topic, I would like to welcome on stage Yash Parashuri, head of the wholesale product team at ICICI Lombard, to address the gathering about the new age risk that businesses face today. A big round of applause for him.
So the objective of this research was to assess the understanding and preparedness of Indian business houses towards new risks, in which more than 100 key opinion leaders views were taken for sectors more than 2,000 crore of a turnover, and decision-making were there from all primary, secondary, and tertiary sector. So the first question was, which are the risks which gives you a sleepless night? So the traditional risks continue to be the most critical for India Inc., which is property, assets, machinery breakdown. And the important one was employee health and accident, which was the second, primarily because of the service sector's input on that. So traditional risks continue to be the most important. But when the question was changed to new age risks, the new age risks were primarily on a data theft and cyber. 47% of the population mentioned the data theft through both traditional and non-traditional new age risks, employee fidelities, the IP loss, and the cyber risk, which is basically realizing into denial of services, the data breaches, and the privacy leakages causing penalties onto the various corporates. The question was, how are these new age risks, which are the risks which are gaining precedence? So in that, as expected, all the important, the new age risks, data theft, cyber, third party liability, machinery equipment, the risks which are basically leading to more of a liability kind of a losses were taking more precedence. So you see the new age risks have basically are the more worrisome factor for the corporates. 73% of the businesses feels that new age risks are becoming more important than traditional one. And when the question came to what are the challenges faced by these new age risks, so the point was that every incident is unique. So when there was a WannaCry, there was no other earlier strategy which basically worked. When there was a Petya, there was a confusion whether it's a cyber war or whether it's another cyber attack which is happening on this. So every incident is unique. So the problem with the corporates is how do you plan for this? How to identify the source, which are the positions that they need to basically protect most on this? And when the question came, how India Inc. is, are they prepared for the new age risks? So the unequipped systems, paucity of skilled manpower, and lack of understanding from senior management was leading to the low preparedness. So this was the view of a sizable, large size companies which they felt, in which 41% were felt that existing systems are not equipped because they don't know from which source the attack could be. 73% of the insurers felt that insurers are in India are moderately well equipped to handle these new age risks depending upon the insurer and the experience. And mainly this was coming from the fact that these insurance companies have handled these kind of a cyber claims across various industries. That's one. And the second thing is the kind of a financial indemnity they basically provide to the customers. So they felt that the insurance companies are suitably placed to handle these kind of a risks. On a further drill down of this question, we basically asked them to rank who can manage better. Is the self-insured or the insurer who can manage that better? And we took the weighted average score of that. And this is what the score looks like in this. If you see, the main thing were third-party liability, casualty, cyber, and of course the intellectual cloud computing foreign business, but the participation was extremely small on that. So the main factor was 78% felt property and assets, which is a traditional insurance, but on the employee health and accident, cyber and third-party liability casualty were the outstanding points which they felt that insurance companies can handle it better. If I have to sum it up to conclude, new age risks are gaining importance for India Inc. Unlike traditional risks, new age risks are much more uncertain and every incident is unique. Business is not as prepared as they prepared for the traditional risks because they have been handling it for quite a period of time. And prevention is better than cure. Insurers perceived to moderately equipped to deal with the new age risks. And critical for insurance companies is to educate companies on new age risk and their role in the mitigation of the same. And finally, design products that can cater to the specific new age risks on this. So these were this is the summary of all the findings which the research report says.
This year, as a part of the India Risk Management Awards, ICICI Lombard conducted a special panel discussion on managing new age risks.
We have an eclectic mix of panelists here. But before that, I just like to give a small preface, actually. They say a ship is safe in the harbor, but that is not the place for the ship to be. No risk, no gain. So risk and gain are like two sides of the same coin. So how do you balance this? So while discussing the research report today, I hope the eclectical panel will throw light on how to manage risk and rewards. So let me welcome on stage Mr. Dinya Jivasha, Global Head and President, Corporate Risk and Insurance Management, SR. Mr. Alok Agarwal, Executive Director, ICICI Lombard. Mr. Anil Gambhir, CFO, Blue Dart. I think we are waiting the fourth panel. We'll join it, Bharat Panchal, the Senior Vice President, Head of National Payments Corporation of India. I'm going to start with the findings, but before that, I want to talk to Alok Agarwal. What was the objective behind this report? And what are the findings in your own words? Yes, put it up. I want in your.
So basically, we are a company which is in the business of risk management. And we had a hunch to begin with that there are some risks that the new age risks which the corporates are not aware of. And there are some risks which they are not prepared for. But before arriving at this conclusion, we wanted an opinion from some of the key opinion leaders of the industry to arrive at that. And that is why this research report has been conducted.
Okay, before getting into the findings, one more quick question. Looking at the emerging scenario, are insurers like you making any change in your business focus or the way you go about insuring risk for your clients?
So basically, we as an insurance company, we are in the business of doing risk transfer. So if there is a risk which is there with the client, we assume that risk at a price. But before that, our job is not only to take the risk which is there with the corporates, but also to make them aware of the risks that are around and make ourselves aware. We look at the global scenario and we look at the reinsurers and we borrow expertise from them. Okay. And then make the clients aware that this is happening in global industry. We have some case studies of India, India-specific cases. For example, you take this cyber case, a cyber risk.
Yeah.
Before it became prevalent in India, the international market had started taking cyber risk cover maybe 3-4 years before Indian market warmed up to it. And there were instances which happened in the global market, which we used to show as a case study that this kind of risk can happen. But once incident started happening in India, that the awareness as well as the risk management on this kind of risk started increasing.
Okay.
Till it was only a case study and theoretical exercise, people were, some of the companies which were progressive, they did appreciate it and they did put some risk management practices behind it. But it has, over the years, as it has, the number of incidents have increased in India, the corporates in India have warmed up to it.
Okay, so basically what you're doing is you're alerting your client, doing hand-holding and also guiding them.
Yes.
Is the right way to sum it up?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, let me go to the first findings. Traditional risks continue to be most critical for India Incorporated. Over 50% of the respondents say that property and assets, employee health and accident, machinery and equipment emerge as the most crucial risk to business.
Yes.
So my question to the two panelists is, do these findings surprise you? Because they are not new age risk, they are traditional risk.
No, they don't, because even now we don't see the insurance industry has warmed up enough to new age risks. Maybe because they do not find it commercially viable, because the industry, corporates themselves have not woken up to the new age risks.
Okay.
And new age risks are difficult to comprehend. As we saw, they are unique in their own way and no two risks are similar.
So Dinesh, what I'm trying to say, the traditional risk is gaining a better...
They are not gaining. I would say they are gaining. In fact, new age risks are gaining over traditional risks because we see more of... say a D&O cover being taken now because of class action suits coming into play, or now with the IBC Act coming into force, there's this new breed of people called resolution professionals.
So okay.
They require specialized sort of covers. Then of course this thing about cyber risks, social media, regulatory risk, environment risk. So they are all gaining in importance. But even today, like when
traditional risks continue to play important role.
Yes.
Let me get the logistic, Anil. How do you react to this findings?
Sure, I'm not surprised. Reason being, what you can see and easily quantify, things and easily get somebody's shoulder that, look, you are responsible for this. That's where people think the risk they have said is physical thing, or the thing where property is lost, or, something has happened, which one can easily see and quantify. But having said that, now markets are gearing up. Markets are now looking at newer avenues, and with the expansion of technology, which is a recent phenomena if you look at it. I think in times to come, this perception will change.
Bharat Panchal, Senior Vice President and Head Risk Management, National Payments Corporation, joins us. Bharat, welcome to the show. I think we went ahead, so we'll come back to some of the questions to you.
Today should be more conscious of geopolitical risk and the polarization which is taking place. See, there was once upon a time globalization. Now what we see is polarization. And this is going to be a huge threat to every country. like Mr. Gambhir just said, that, you know, today we have these trade sanctions or people putting duties and then the trade wars which are going on between countries. So, you know, these are the real, what should I say, new age risks which are going to have major ramifications on economies.
I will come back to both of you. I think since Bharat is here, I'll go back to my previous finding because he's into cyberspace, he's more into digital payment. So the findings is basically new age risk are data theft and cyber crime. 47% respondents say it's data theft and 39% say it's cyber crime. 10% respondents say it's cloud computing and 4% say it is geopolitical. So how do you de-risk your business? You're somebody in the National Payment Corporation of India. It's a very tough, or is it you've insulated your business well enough?
See, as long as your data is not theft, things are fine. When you lose your identity, you lose your credential, then everything is going to be ruined. And that's a precise thing happening in today's world. Because India, as such, we are late into the digital movement. But when we have entered, it's a leapfrog. And today, the world is talking about the growth story of digital payment, especially what we have paved the road in the last 8 years. It has taken into a completely different league altogether. I would say, fortunately, so far we are not exposed to that risk because whatever small or medium incident have happened in our country so far, like one bank lost some around 100 crores last year and so on and so forth. But the damages are not seen that much as what we have seen in rest of the world. Reason why maybe people are not coming forward and probably they are not in position to understand what has happened with them. Till the time they come to know, and the kind of hindrance in the judiciary and law enforcement where you go and file a complaint, bank are not ready to take complaint of person, or judiciary is not supporting the whole system. But the major point is that entities are not liable to reveal that their institute is hacked or that their data is breached. Because in US, if why Yahoo or LinkedIn and all that, they are not Sadhu Mahatma like people that they will go and tell voluntarily that we have been hacked or our data is stolen. Because they abide by the law and regulation of that country, therefore they need to submit to the exchanges and the regulator that they have been breached. That has not come at in our country.
Where does risk come for you? From traditional risk or it's a new risk in your kind of business?
It is completely new risk.
For you?
It is absolutely new risk.
Traditional risk is you're totally
and sir, I would further like to add that it is nothing to do only with the payment. It is with everything. Because when you are linking your everyday, your digital footprint itself, let me tell you where.
So what gives you sleepless night?
Okay. The sleepless night is one, the data security. What if my data is stolen? But larger sleepless issue is that what if I detect so late? Because by the time damages happen, see today if I have to quote this some data, the 87% of breaches happen in few minutes.
Yeah.
And that is the data I'm talking about worldwide and especially the Asia and part. If 87% breaches are happening in minute, 68% are detected after months, whether the minutes and months. So if nobody can claim that yes, we can prevent fully, we can secure fully from the cyber crime. No, it is not. Nobody
has.
You're
saying in the real-time world, what is you're going to detect after a month?
Yes. So one can say yes, if I am breached, I will take this much of time to detect and respond back on that. I think that's a key where everybody is lacking today because we all are putting system and so on, newer tools are coming and we are putting. But what if we do not detect? Damages happen. But how I can stop further damage, that is a larger risk or that is a larger challenge for any security professional.
So what kind of de-risking strategy are you putting in place to avoid this kind of nightmares?
Okay. So if I see from the India perspective, the larger issue is digital illiteracy. I think that word is a little,
Okay, digital illiteracy. Okay.
Digital illiteracy. If we talk about our country, we have product for people, those who are from class. We have product for people, those who are from mass, like USSD, Star 1998.
Okay.
And we have UPI as well. But what is the problem is that people do not understand the implication of what they are sharing, what they are doing, because it's a general Indian mentality. If I get free Wi-Fi, then better I'll get free Wi-Fi than using my dongle because I'm getting free Wi-Fi. Now I'm getting free Wi-Fi, I'll tend to do my banking transaction and I'll put my username, password, PIN and everything.
next moment it is stolen. So that education is the biggest, because there is no technology. No technology can prevent every cybercrime. No, it is impossible. All we can de-risk only by the better and better customer education. And that is what is the need of time. Because tomorrow, day by day, we are becoming paperless. It is not only from the banking system, but in every aspect, we are becoming paperless. Therefore, we are increasing our digital footprint in every business we are doing. Every day-to-day transaction, everything we do today, we are putting our digital footprint. Now, the digital footprint, I should know that. Let me give one small example. Somebody cross from wrong side of my car, and I just caught his number, and I reached out that person LinkedIn profile and Facebook profile. Can you imagine how it is? Because there's a portal, Vahan, where you put the number of that vehicle, you'll get the name of person, sure. Then you go to LinkedIn profile, then you go to Facebook profile, and you can completely have a picture of what kind of this fellow is. So if that risk is not known to many people. Rather, largely people are not aware that my digital identity is
so you're saying the double-edged sword cuts both ways.
Exactly.
There's a benefit and the flip side to it.
Exactly.
No, he was talking about educating. When you look at the portfolio of our clients, what's the sense you get? Because he said digital illiteracy.
So I what we feel is that risk management as a function has started getting importance in the last 2-3 years. Not these are the digital companies, they are anyway into that cyber world, okay. and they are aware, much more aware than others. But I'm taking traditional companies and the companies which have come up in the last 10-15 years. Even there, the risk management as a function has started gaining importance in the last 3-4 years. There are hundreds of risks.
Is it compliance issues?
So it is not more compliance, but what is happening is the awareness and the importance given to risk function has only come of age in the last 3-4 years. Okay. Even if you take
we are being heard. We are being heard as a risk professional. We are being heard in every
discussion. That's good to hear, actually. You are being heard.